Hi, Sourav.
Hello.
This is the trophy you won for last year's 2018 World Billiards Championships. How do you think you're going to go this year?
Well, it's a million-dollar question, honestly, because the depth that we have in the field of billiards today is absolutely incredible. There's so many fantastic players all over the world, and you know, to pick a winner is so tough. Even last year, you know, I know what a tough time I had, you know, especially in the semi-final. I was down by 550 points, and to win that match and then, you know, the finals, it's a huge deal, honestly. To pick a winner, very tough. I think there are five or six solid players in the world today who are capable of making 500 plus breaks on their given day. So, but yeah, I'm very confident. It's winning the world title last year was a huge monkey off my back, and I come here with more confidence, and of course with having refined my skills a little more, having changed a few, you know, technical aspects of my game, I feel more confident. And as I said, it's a huge monkey off my back, and that's what sport is about. You know, you need that one big break or a win, and a world title is a world title in any sport. So I feel good, but predicting, you know, what the result would be would something that I can't do. But yeah, I know I'm going to give it my best, and yeah, I fancy my chances. So let's see how it goes.
Great, great. So how are you finding the conditions in Melbourne? How are the tables running?
Oh, I honestly, I mean, if I have to speak about the city, if I have to speak about Melbourne as a city, as Australia as a country, I love coming here, and I've been coming here for the last 12, 15 years. I came here when I was very young, first time. And to be honest with you, I feel like at home in Melbourne because I've been here so many times. I sort of know my ways around here. So that's as far as the city goes. The weather is fantastic, and I also believe that Melbourne gets voted the best city to live in for so many years and stuff like that. So and I know why it is so, because it's such a beautiful city. People are friendly, warm. And coming to the conditions, I think RACV is a fantastic club. So niche and so you know, beautiful. And especially the billiard room that they have, you know, to have that kind of a setup and infrastructure in a place like Melbourne, it's just fantastic. The conditions are beautiful. So many tables, they look gorgeous. So many people back home have asked me, you know, wow, you know, this is such a fabulous place. Where is this? So I think it's great conditions, especially for billiards. All the tables have been reclothed, which is a great thing. And I think even the players are unified in their opinion that these conditions are great to make big breaks and fitting to hold a world championship.
So how do you practice billiards? Do you have a routine?
Well, yes and no. My dad, who's basically my coach, and he's also won the world title. He won the world title in 1990.
Wow.
And, you know, I've sort of grown up, you know, being a world champion's son. It was always a very, very heavy burden on me, you know. And finally, you know, winning the world title last year was, you know, it was a big deal for us. So he's quite a stickler for discipline and, you know, on and off the table. So I don't have a set routine as such, but yes, before a big event, I do make sure that I'm, you know, giving 6 to 8 hours of solid practice. And so does my father. He makes sure that I'm not, you know, sort of meandering away from that routine. In fact, before coming here for the World Championship, we are having a big festival in India, especially in my hometown. It's called Durga Puja. It's huge. It's massive. I mean, you have millions of people thronging from different parts of the country to my city to worship this particular idol called Durga Ma, and it's huge. But unfortunately, I didn't go out anywhere. There was no plans with friends, because I knew I had to put in, you know, those hours. And once, you know, our sport is such that it's so emotionally draining that once your practice is done, you don't have anything left in you to be going out and having a good time in the festivities. So, and especially because I play snooker as well. So for me to balance both the games, billiards, snooker, they're like chalk and cheese, honestly. I mean, to the layman, you'd probably feel that, you know, it's pretty similar, but it's actually chalk and cheese. It's very different. So I try to juggle my time in between both. So I'm playing a little bit of snooker, a little bit of billiards. So nothing fixed as such, but yeah, I think the main thing is to put in the hours and to be match fresh. And I think it works for me, you know, not to exhaust myself playing too many tournaments. So Well, yeah, I'm happy with the way it's going, and I'm happy with the way I train, and especially having a world champion father as my coach, it really helps. You know, it's got its plus and the negatives as well, because he's really strict. But you know, it's nice. It's I've got a pretty set routine that way, so I'm happy with it right now. Okay.
So there's a $24,000 prize for a 1,000 break. Do you think that somebody will get it?
Well, to be honest with you, as I said before, there are some really solid players in Frey in this championship. The conditions are absolutely fantastic. So I wouldn't be surprised, honestly, if there is a 1,000 break. But having said that, again, it's a huge milestone, a 1,000 break, and that too with the Borkland rule. And whoever gets that, it's going to be worthy of a lot of appreciation, because it's such a tough feat to achieve in modern day billiards. So I wouldn't put it past some of the top players. Yeah. But again, it's a tough task. But yeah, we'll see how it goes.
Great.